different toys, jet skis, Rams packages, Zodiacs that they would deploy from the C-130, motorcycles. They can go out into the mountains, over the water, and this demonstration right now will be flown at 3,000 feet, 130 knots. You'll be seeing four pararescue men come to a simulated survivor out over the water. So keep your eye out in the water, and the PJs will be landing right to a survivor, just at center stage, about quarter of a mile off the beach.
The C-130 Hercules is one amazing airplane. First flown back in the early 1950s, the folks at Lockheed have continued to produce this airframe, and over 2,000 have now been built and continue to come off the production line at Martin Marietta's plant in Atlanta, Georgia.
And the PJs will be jumping out today. CMS Sergeant Jeff Baker, Staff Sergeant Sam Prescott, Tech Sergeant Doug DeDeacon, and Master Sergeant Art Kakis. So keep your eye out for the 106 Rescuing Power Rescue Men.
I said Lockheed Martin Marietta. It's Lockheed Martin's Marietta, Georgia production facility. They're out.
Okay, we have four parachutists out. Four good shoots. There's a survivor out, probably about 200 yards out off the beach. You can see one of our boats out there in a circle. And that's the target right now for the pararescue men.
As I mentioned earlier, these parachutes are very steerable, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Folks with the 106 Rescue Wing are your neighbors, I think. Wouldn't you say that, sir?
That's it. We have about 1,000 members of the 106 Rescue Wing. About 300 of us are full-timers. And then about 700 people we have working out at the base are part-timers. We have doctors, we have lawyers, we have dentists, we have airline pilots, New York City firemen, police officers.
Helicopter pilot to Suffolk County Police. will be flying at 10 knots.
And there's one parachute in the water.
So when you say 80 knots, that's just shy of 100 miles an hour.
That's correct. And there's our second and third pararescue into the water.
And one more just went in as well.
Right-hand side of the aircraft, which is where the pilot's sitting. And you have the aerial gunner, who's also on the left-hand side, who is a scanner to make sure if we're in a remote area. He's making sure that we don't have any flying into any kind of an obstruction. So here you go. The flight engineer is talking the pilot into the hoist, and they'll be recovering the survivor. What they're going to be doing is dropping what's called a Stokes litter, and it's got a flotation collar around it, which would stabilize a person who may have a neck or a back injury. There's different ways of extracting. If somebody is mobile, they can put down what's called a forest penetrator with a flotation collar, and that can hoist up three people at a time.
Flight engineer and those guys who are climbing up those ladders. And if you look carefully, ladies and gentlemen, you can see the actual weight of the helicopter. You can see the weight of the helicopter being supported by that rotary wing as the blades tend to cone up a little bit. Maximum weight of the HH-60, somewhere around, 21,000 pounds?
Yeah, 22,000 pounds on max gross weight for the HH-60.
It's a heck of a lifter, and the Army and the Air Force and the Marines and the Coast Guard have all been using it.
As a matter of fact, we just attended a rollout ceremony of the first HC-130J model.
Now let's take a look off to the right because the helicopter's on its way in. This is going to give you folks a chance to give them a wave, and I think you guys are set up to wave back.
That's right. Actually, what they're going to be doing is coming to a hover center stage and deploying the American flag. On this Memorial Day, when we think about all our veterans and those who are deployed.
Come on, Dad.
Out of the silence.
I feel it coming on, and I feel it coming on.
Okay, here's our HH-60, and again, if we can have a moment of silence as they deploy. In memory of all those who have fallen and all our service members who are overseas at this time. Recruiters out there, they can tell you all about the unit. So again, once again, On behalf of Colonel Owens, our 106 Rescue Wing Commander, and the 1,000 members of the 106 Rescue Wing, I want to thank you for your support, and we'll see you next year.
Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, a nice round of applause for the 106.